through life, this living in the new realm while existing in the present realm. This is called life for the believer. This is what Paul describes as fighting the good fight. These ideals that he gives, where we're empowered by God to change, where we actually have to put the rubber to the road and be Christians, be disciples of Jesus. And guess what? It is not easy. Paul takes this unity theme, God uniting man to himself in the beginning of Ephesians, God uniting men together with each other, Jew and Gentile, creating a new humanity. It unites this theme ultimately to the most personal and the hardest relationships to be united with people. He talks about marriage. He talks about kids and parents. He even talks about slaves and masters, and the best way to interpret that these days is to look at employers and employees. How hard is it to get along with bosses? How hard is it to get along with coworkers? This is not only a place to practice the unity of Christ in our hearts, the oneness that God's bringing into the world. It's the only place to do it. A friend of mine once said, the light that shines the furthest shines the brightest at home, close to you. This is why Paul talks about in this final chapter taking a stand, of fighting off the works of the enemy, of powers and principalities. It's easy to love people from a distance. People close to us, that takes real love. That takes agape. That takes selfless love. And so Paul talks about weapons to defeat powers and principalities. That people are never our enemies. Our enemies are the devil, our flesh, and the world. And the truth is none of those three will conspire to help us to love each other, to love the way Christ loves. And so we need our armor. We need every bit of it. We need to employ different pieces of armor, different aspects of the kingdom of God in order to win the battles. Ultimately, we need to have thick skin at times. Ultimately, we need to just choose to love. No matter what we want to do, no matter what our flesh is screaming to do, we choose to love. And the beautiful thing about God is as we step into it, He provides the power. Soon we find we can love. We can forgive. We are at one with others, not just on the outside, but actually on the inside. This is the battle. This is what God calls us to do. This is who we are. Ephesians is all about unity with God, unity with people, so that when Jesus comes back, there is unity.